everyone. I am Ivan Yogi, a student of kindergarten. In this video, I will present the story The Three Little Pigs with the help of hand and finger puppets. So, let's begin. Once, a mother pig said to her three little piglets, "It's time for you to go out into the world and set up homes of your own." As she kissed each one goodbye, she said, "Remember, my sweet piglet, watch out for the big bad wolf." Off went the three little pigs to seek their fortunes. The first took the high road, the second took the low road, and the third took the middle road. The first little pig hadn't gone far when he met a man carrying a huge bale of straw. "Please, sir, may I have some of that straw to build a house?" asked the little pig. "Indeed, you may," said the man, and he gave him a big bundle. The little pig piled the straw this way and that way, and he ended up with a shaky straw house. Just as he was settling in, along came the big bad wolf.
"Little pig, little pig, let me come in," called the wolf.
"Not by the hair on my chinny chin chin," cried the little pig.
"Then I will laugh, and I will puff, and I will blow your house in,"
growled the wolf. With a huff and a puff, he blew the shaky straw house to shreds. And gobble, gobble, gulp, gulp, he swallowed the first little pig. The second little pig walked along the low road until he met a man pushing a cart stacked high with sticks.
"Please, sir, may I have some of those sticks to build a house?" asked the little pig.
"Indeed, you may," said the man, and he gave him a large stack. The little pig piled the sticks this way and that way, and he ended up with a very rickety stick house. Soon after he moved in, along came the big bad wolf.
"Little pig, little pig, let me come in," called the wolf.
"Not by the hair on my chinny chin chin," cried the little pig.
"Then I will huff, and I will puff, and I will blow your house in,"
growled the wolf. With a huff and a puff, he blew the rickety stick house to pieces, and gobble, gobble, gulp, gulp, he swallowed the second little pig. The third little pig followed the middle road until he met a man pulling a great wagon load of bricks.
"Please, sir, may I have some of those bricks to build myself a house?" asked the little pig.
"Indeed, you may," said the man, and he gave him a generous pile. The little pig laid the bricks side by side. Then he piled them just so, one on top of the other. This little pig ended up with a sturdy brick house. He was busy hanging curtains when along came the big bad wolf.
Little pig, let me come in," called the wolf.
"Not by the hair on my chinny chin chin," cried the little pig.
Then I will huff, and I will puff, and I will blow your house in,
growled the wolf. He huffed and he puffed. He huffed until his nose turned red. He puffed until his throat went dry. But no matter how hard he tried, he couldn't blow the sturdy brick house in.
You will never get me, you old blowhard,
loud the little pig. The wolf took a minute to catch his breath. Then he put a big, wide smile on his face and said sweetly,
"Dear little pig, do you like turnips?"
"I certainly do," replied the little pig.
"Then I'll call for you tomorrow morning at 7 o'clock, said the wolf. "I will show you where to find the juiciest turnips in Farmer Flag's field."
"I don't trust that wolf one bit," said the little pig to himself. So he was up and away to Farmer Flag's field at 6 o'clock the next morning. When the wolf came by at 7, he smelled turnips cooking.
"You are too late,"
the little pig called out. "I have already been to Farmer Flag's and back." The wolf was angry, but he smiled and said,
"Dear little pig, do you like apples?"
"I certainly do," replied the little pig.
"Then I'll call for you tomorrow morning at 6 o'clock, said the wolf. "I will show you where to find the ripest apples in Granny Greeny's orchard.
We will pick a basket together." When the wolf came by the next morning, the little pig wasn't home. The wolf quickly set off for Granny Greeny's. There he spotted the little pig high up in the apple tree, filling his basket.
"We were supposed to pick apples together,"
the wolf called up to him in a growly voice.
"Here's your share,"
the little pig called back. He took 3 plump apples from the basket and threw them as far as he could.
"Catch them if you can,"
he shouted, while the wolf chased after the apples. The little pig scrambled out of the tree and ran home. When the wolf came back, the little pig was gone.
"Where did the little pogo go?"
growled the wolf. Off he raced to the little pig's house. He peeked in the window. There was the little pig, safe inside, peeling apples. The wolf was furious, but he smiled and said,
"Dear little pig, do you like fairs?"
"I certainly do," replied the little pig.
"Then I'll call for you this afternoon at 3 o'clock, said the wolf. "We'll go to Shanklin Fair together."
"I will be ready for you," promised the little pig.
"You won't fool me this time," muttered the wolf.
He arrived at the little pig's house 30 minutes early, but once again, the little pig wasn't home. The wolf set off to Shanklin Fair, dreaming of a fine pork chop dinner. Meanwhile, the little pig had gone to the fair all by himself. He had seen everything there was to see and was on his way home carrying the large butter churn he had bought.
As he came over the top of a high hill, the little pig saw the wolf at the bottom. As quick as you can say, big bad wolf, the little pig turned the butter churn on his side and jumped in. Thumpity bump, down the hilly road. Bumpity thump, he sent the wolf flying so high into the sky that he was never seen again. The third little pig rode all the way to his front door. Then he went inside and had a delicious dinner of boiled turnips and warm apple bread spread thickly with fresh creamy butter. So friends, what we learn from this story is that we must work towards our goal with perseverance and not get flustered in difficult situations. I hope you like this story presentation. There are other videos in my YouTube channel which I hope you may find enjoyable. Thank you. Bye.